Hello everyone, this is a lesson on contingency tables. We're gonna look at one table. This is a section on probability. So the contingency table, it's a table that compares two things. This one is actually comparing, they did an experiment where they give people pills and then they check the side effects. So they were comparing males and females. These ones had side effects, the males and the females. These ones had no side effects. So when you look at this table, they've given you a table where there are numbers missing. You see here, it's total, and there it's total. The total that is here at the end is the total number of people that were surveyed. So when you get a question like this, the first thing, you fill up the gaps that you have, and then before you start answering the questions, usually the first question they will ask you to fill up the gap. Let's do that. Okay. The first row had side effects. The number of males that had side effects were 150. The females, we don't know, but the total is 300. So you always look for the row where you are missing one. So I'm gonna have 3,000 minus 1,005. So it means the females were 1,005 as well. Now I can find this one. The total is 500. So here it will be 2,000. Not 500, 5,000. Right? So I can find this one. If the total is 2,000, it means it's 1,000 here. Yeah. And then I can find this one. 1,005 plus... it's 2,005. And then I also can find this one to also be 2,005. Then your table is filled. Then you can start looking at the first question.
Okay, let's look at the first question. They said determine the probability that a person chosen at random had no side effect and male. So you remember probability, you have to write probability, no side effect and male. When you use the contingency table, you go to male and no side effect. So the number is 1,000. And then they say a person chosen at random. So we're going to use the total, 5,000. And then you punch that into your calculator. You get that it's 1 over 5 or in a decimal is 0.2. You don't need both. When you have one, it's enough. Let's look at number B. Let's look at the next question. They say determine the probability that a person that has side effect will be female. So what is our total? Our total is the total of side effect. Everyone that has side effect. In that group, what do we want? We want the female. So the probability of side effect female. So the total, let's look at that. We go to side effect and female and see where they meet. This is side effect and female, so it's 1,005. But our denominator, it's divided by everyone that has side effect. We are only concentrating on the one that has side effect, not everyone. So here will be 3,000. So our answer will be 1 over 2 or 0.5. Let's look at the next question.
Look at number C. Show that being female and no and not having side effect are independent events. With independent events, being female and no side effect and must be the same as having no side effect and multiplying female. So we're gonna start by finding the probability of being female and no side effect. Probability of being female and no side effect. Let's look at female. Female, no side effect. It's 1,000 divided by 5,000, which is 0.5. This part must be the same as probability of female multiplied by probability of no side effects. When you multiply these two probabilities,
you must get the same number as that one. Then if that happens, the two events are independent. Let's find the probability of failing.
Before we continue with this one, I made a mistake here. 1000 divided by it's 1 over 5, which is 0.2, not 0.5. It's 0.2. Okay, let's come here. Female, probability of female. You see, female, the total number of female, 2005 divided by the total is 5000 multiplied by no side effect. No side effect is 2000 divided by 5000. Right? Then take your calculator and multiply that. Okay, whole fraction 2005 divided by 5000 multiplied by fraction 2000 divided by 5000 is equals to, you get 1 over 5, which is the same as 0.2. Now, do you see that probability of female and no side effect is equals to probability of female multiplied by probability of no side effects? So if you have that, as we have calculated here, and they are equal, so it means that events are independent. This is how you prove that the two events are independent. If you can prove that the probability of female, the end part, is multiplying the two probabilities and you get the same answer, then those two events are independent. This is the end of our lesson. Thank you for watching.